what I'm looking at is that I would be providing a customer with a generic link to go to a form. So there's no you know, identifying information about who they are or anything in there. And the first page would be a place where they could say enter their email address. Uh-huh. And then in between going to the second page, I would like to be able to check in the CRM to see if that email's there. And if it is, then to be able to sort of pre-fill information on the second page for corresponding to that email address. Is that something that's...
So you want only on the second page to check if this email address exists in your database, in your CRM?
It would be basically I'm using the first page like a login. Because I don't know who the person is who's coming to my form. However, it's very likely that this is an existing customer of mine. And so rather than me asking them all sorts of questions that my database already knows, I would like to be able, I'm trying to figure out a way to be able to, to be able to say, hey, I recognize your face, through the first page of the form.
There is no way to do that. There is no way to inquire. No, the only thing that you can do, there are two things that you can do. Mm-hmm. So one, let's assume that this is a, let's grab here page breaks. So this is page number one and this is page number two.
Yep.
In page number one, you can have the Zoho CRM field, which located here. And based on that, you can identify the user, but that needs to come from your system. There need to be a special link that someone clicks and the system will identify him.
Right.
And
right.
Then
so,
every-
so, it, so it, it can't be a generic link in order for that to work.
No, but right. Let's assume that you do have a generic link and let me just delete the CRM. In the integration, you can have the integration based on, no, but you will need it. It will not let you do it. The update can come only if the Zoho CRM field exists and that's connecting both records.
Right.
Now, what you also can do is just in the form, just to ask, leave page, so you can ask here, are you an existing or new customer? If he says yes, then just tell him, please send me an email and I will send you a customized form, will save your time or something like that, that there will be a benefit for the user to do it. And if he's not an existing customer, then he's going to a different route, which going to fill all the details.
Yeah, I was wondering, there was another workaround that I had thought about that would be that they could enter in, say, their email address. And I just have it would start with a one-page form. So mm-hmm. they just put in their email address and then they hit send and then mm-hmm. they would be referred to a second form. But in between, but when they go to that second form, the CRM has taken their email address from the first form and used that as a reference for populating the information.
So what you can do, it's a bit more complicated than that, but your direction is very, very good.
Mm-hmm.
So let's create here a diagram. So we have here, that will be form one. Now, for one, we'll send, let's say, email exists, okay, or that's the other option.
Exactly.
Okay, but you will need to send it to the CRM. You will not send it to another form. So once you send it to the CRM, so this is going both ways. Yeah. Once you send it to the CRM, you can run a simple script that is checking exist or does not exist. And based on that, we are going to send an email to the customer or to the lead with the correct link. If there will be, for example, an existing customer, then actually in both cases, what we can do, so that would be probably the easiest way. When the form is coming in, you are basically creating a new record if this person does not exist. So based on the email, it will create a new person. So let's say first name, last name, and email, because you cannot create a record just by the email.
Yeah, so we can just focus on the thing that the email exists, because this is something that I'm really anticipating that these are going to be existing customers. It's just my problem is I spoke to you before about that I'm building this e-course, and the yep. platform on which I'm building the e-course, it doesn't yet let me embed information. It's just I can only put a generic link. So after they do the course, I want to send them to the form to answer some questions. But I can never get in any information about who they are when I'm sending them to the form. But I know that they're a customer, like a client already.
So what if you will have a short form, first name, last name, email, and it will ask them if they like to answer, let's say, a short survey or something like that. And once they send that, it goes to your CRM, and there will be an automation that will send them this customized link. And the customized link will link them to the profile, because you will need to have this customized link being sent from the CRM.
Right. Okay. And the customized link cannot just be sent to another, like a second form that they would be forwarded to?
It is a second form, but it's not first form and then second form. It's first form goes to the CRM, understanding who the person is.
Yeah.
And then let's see if it's a contact. From the contact system, there will be an automation that will send a special link to this person. Without this special link, the CRM will not know how to match it.
Right. Okay. 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 I got to do a little bit more brainstorming. This isn't something I need to be setting up, any time in the next, week or two or something. But I'm going to try and find some solution that just makes it as seamless as possible for a situation that has lots of seams in it at the moment. So.
It's just in terms of the CRM, when you're, let's see if I have any forms here. No, I don't have forms. But when basically you inject a link, the link will have some kind of a question mark and a long variable after that. It's identifying the specific user.
Yeah.
So that's really the problem. We need this variable.
Yeah. Can I just check in with something? The other alternative I'm wondering is if this might be something that Create would be made to do, that if I could find that, I don't want to learn how to work with Create. It's sounding to me like it'd be a lot of work, but if I could find someone who knows how to work with Create or if there's some other tool that could be used to, make a custom bridge.
I will tell you the problem. So let's say that, you do have a Zoho Creator application that is inquiring based on the email. That means that I can go to your page. I can type in different email addresses and it will load all the information of all your customers for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I can steal all your database just by using this page. Yeah. So you can do it, but I don't know if that's what you want to do.
It doesn't sound terribly attractive.
It's not really attractive.
No, I call it unattractive. Yeah. Okay. Well, I will put that back in my pressure cooker brain here, and no doubt be back to you with another question along that line.
No problem, Robert. No problem.
Thanks again, Leon.
And anytime.
Okie dokes.